What is going on, guys? Alex here, and this is the Canon EOS M10, the most underrated mirrorless camera from Canon yet. So let's get into it. The new Kinston A400 brings SSDs to everyone, boasting super fast speeds and a low price tag. Find out more in the video description or at the end of this video. So guys, this is the Canon EOS M10, the camera that does not get enough credit for what it has to offer. I currently have a 15-45mm lens paired with this camera, so anything that I show you that's been shot on this camera will be shot with a 15-45mm lens, unless I say otherwise, and it'll be down in the bottom left corner. So as with all my videos, let's start with the design. Along the top of the camera, we find a pop-up flash which is activated from the side. This will give you a lot better photos in low light conditions, although of course if you're doing landscape photography with a wide-angle lens such as this one, long exposures will always give you a better result. I think by including the flash on the side, Canon were trying to justify why they don't have a hot shoe on this camera, and it didn't really work as well as they probably hoped it would. I like the flash, I'm probably not going to use it that often because I prefer long exposures, but it does not excuse the lack of a hot shoe. Just next to the flash are the two microphones that are used for the video, which are conveniently placed so when the screen is popped up, your voice sound, especially if you're vlogging with the camera like this, your voice will be projected down and into the microphone reflected off the screen. Next to the microphones, we find the mode dial and power switch, which is all fused into one unit. Here you can choose between automatic photos, manual photos, and video mode, and inside of the dial is the power button. I haven't had any issues yet when I'm changing the mode that I would accidentally press the power button, so it's conveniently placed and there's no issues with it. The shutter button is just on the right of the power and mode dial, and it actually is surrounded by the adjustment knob, and this you can use to adjust the shutter speed or aperture, which you can change its function in the settings. It isn't the quietest of things, so it will be noticeable if you do adjust it during video mode, and of course that wouldn't happen if you had an external microphone, but unfortunately it does happen, so just be aware of that. And just next to the shutter and control buttons is the record button. On the left hand side of the camera is the mini USB and HDMI ports, as well as the SD card slot. These are actually covered with the same material that the body is made of overall, which is something I wasn't expecting at this price point. And on the right hand side of the camera is the smartphone connect button, as well as the NFC pad. This means that if you have a phone with enabled NFC, so not the OnePlus 2, you could actually tap your phone next to the camera to transfer your photos from the SD card to the phone, which would actually make uploading things to Instagram or uploading them to the cloud a lot easier. But the Wi-Fi Connect feature with the button actually works just as well. It does take a little bit longer, but overall it's fine. And on the back of the camera is the articulating screen, which is the main attraction to this camera for beginning vloggers. The ability to see exactly what you're shooting is something that most cameras don't actually have these days, although you will be able to flip out the screen on things like the EOS M3. If you have an external microphone on the top, it's kind of useless and you won't be able to use it. It's the same with the original EOS M, which I'm currently shooting this video on, which doesn't even have a flip-out screen, so whilst I was doing the holiday vlog back at Christmas in January, I could not tell what I was filming, and I just had to rely on the fact that the shutter speed was right, and that I was in focus. The viewing angles on this screen are also pretty damn awesome. I haven't had any issues with it whatsoever. You can see it from any angle, so I could look at it top down like this and I can still pretty much see the image on there. And the resolution is fine for framing shots, although it isn't exactly perfect. It isn't one of the sharpest screens that you'll ever see, and it isn't the brightest either, but it is pretty decent for everyday vlogging. One interesting feature that this camera has that most other cameras at this price point don't have is something called focus peaking. And if you don't know what this is when the lens is in manual focus, or if you're using a separate manual focus lens, the camera actually has a feature called focus peaking, which basically highlights all the points of sharpness as if it was doing autofocus with a little red, yellow, or blue line, and you can choose what color you have. And pretty much this helps you then if you're just framing a shot and trying to focus it by eye. It can tell you exactly what's in focus because it can obviously see more detail than you can, and it really does help when you're doing wide angle shots but also manual focusing at the same time. It just makes things a lot easier, and it's something that I definitely didn't expect at this price point. To the right of the screen is the very limited number of buttons. We literally have a menu button, a play button, the delete, the flash button, the information button, and the star, as well as the set button, which you can obviously use whilst you're in the UI. The use of touchscreen on the screen itself does make navigating the menus a hell of a lot easier, and it just basically speeds up your workflow whilst you're trying to change the settings. And although this camera is made of plastic, it actually does feel quite premium. It's got a nice weight to it, even though when you tap it, you can kind of hear a... It isn't the most premium of build qualities, but what can you expect at this price point? What people really want from this camera is video quality, and for that it doesn't disappoint. So this camera has an 18 megapixel APS-C size sensor, which has a crop factor of 1.6. Now if you don't know what any of this basically means that a 15mm lens like the one that I have here would actually be the equivalent to a 24mm lens if you were shooting on a full frame camera. Now unless you've actually shot with a full frame camera, this really doesn't affect you, it's just what a lot of people like to do to make sure that they know exactly what the millimeters are for what lens they're getting. The photo pixel resolution is good enough for Instagram and to use as desktop wallpapers, which is what I've been doing with photos from my original EOS M. But for most of my Instagram posts now, such as on @TechFocusYT, which is where I post some behind the scenes shots, I will actually be using this camera because I can shoot my behind the scenes stuff with this whilst using the main camera as the main camera. So now let's take a look at the video quality. The first thing I'm going to do is actually just point it at myself right now. So we have to move the lens into the shooting position. I'm going to flip up the screen, make sure the shutter speed's right. So this is the video quality of the EOS M10 with face tracking autofocus at 1080p 30 frames a second. This is also at 15mm using the 15-45mm kit lens. So let's just take a look at the autofocus. So I tap the screen over there to tap focus onto the monitor. We can see that there's my script. Right over there, there's a bit of Spotify, there's my PC behind. If I just do a sudden Casey Neistat style zoom in, the autofocus is actually pretty impressive. And now if I just press the little back button, it's back to face tracking autofocus. And it should hopefully lock focus much faster than you'd expect. I can then point it at things like this water bottle, tap to focus, and it literally just jumps focus straight to it. And if I just show you a test without tapping to focus, so if I just point it at things, like there's the monitor, you can see it's just found my face. Sometimes it does do a little bit of focus searching, which is obviously an issue, especially for vloggers, because you want to keep your face in focus most of the time whilst you're recording. But then again, at this price point, what can you expect? Here's a little bit of a cinematic video which I've shot using the 50mm f1.8, the 24mm f2.8, as well as the 15-45mm lenses. So guys, there you have it. This is the EOS M10. I hope you've learned quite a lot about this camera in this video. I personally think it's a brilliant camera for vlogging, especially at the price point. So guys, the main draw to this camera is the ease of use, the compact form factor, and the low price tag. All of these add to a very nice experience when using this camera, although it isn't the best that you'll get. You could go out and spend £3,000 on a camera, but it's unlikely that you'll get 10 times the performance of this £300 camera. Throw it on top of this Manfrotto mini video tripod and you've got a pretty awesome vlogging rig. Although it does lack some key features that we would expect with a camera at this price point, it has a fully articulating screen, which is a big attraction for vloggers. It also has fast autofocus, which is a big attraction for vloggers. And the ability to change your lens with other lenses makes it much more attractive for those who want a budget video camera and can use an external recorder for audio. If you like this video, please drop a like and comment anything that you think I should do for my next video. Subscribe for more content like this and I will catch you guys in my next video. The new Kinston A400 SSDs bring SSDs to everyone, boasting great looks that match any PC build, insane performance when compared to traditional hard drives whilst keeping the price low. For more information, check the link in the video description below. I'm